स्टूडेंट टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी। दिस इज द पार्ट 4 ऑफ आवर लेक्चर सीरीज व्हिच वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड इन दिस चैप्टर पार्ट 3 पार्ट 1 पार्ट 2 पार्ट 3 इज ऑलरेडी कवर्ड। नाउ दिस इज द दिस मे बी द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस थ्योरी पोर्शन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर वर्क पावर एंड एनर्जी। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल स्टडी व्हाट डू मीन बाय द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी। According to the principle of the conservation of energy, that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. Neither be created nor be destroyed. Can only be transformed from one form to another. We have already studied how the energy can be transformed from like solar energy to electrical energy, electric energy to chemical energy to electrical energy, light energy to heat energy, heat energy to light energy. In this way, energy can only be transformed from one form to another. Okay, or in easy words, we can say energy cannot be vanished. Okay, it can only be transformed from one form to another. So today we will discuss some concept related to this topic. First of all, according to the principle of conservation of energy, energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, can only be transformed from one form to another. So at every point the total energy must always remain constant, that is kinetic energy plus potential energy always remain constant, it should be there. Second application is the application of the principle of conservation of energy by taking example of simple pendulum. So here we will take some example to verify our concept which we have discussed over here. So first concept is, first we will prove the kinetic energy plus potential energy always equal to constant. Okay, so suppose for that purpose, suppose we have taken, suppose this is the height h, overall height h is there, suppose this is, and body is placed at point A. Suppose this is the ball placed at point A, this is the point B, and this is the point C. At these three positions, we will determine the total energy of this ball. So at A, okay, at B, and at C. Okay, so at point A, what happened? At point A, potential energy is maximum, that is equal to mgh, while kinetic energy is equal to zero because ball is at rest condition. So total energy at point A, total energy equal to kinetic energy plus potential energy. So total energy is equal to zero plus mgh, that is equal to mgh. So total energy at point A equal to mgh. Now at point B, the ball cover a distance, suppose at point B the ball is thrown and it covers a distance h. So remaining distance will be h minus h, capital H minus h. So at point B, if ball is dropped, then only it will reach the point B. So we know very well, B square equal to U square plus 2GH. Okay, so ball is dropped from rest condition, the V square equal to 2GG. Now you will find, you will notice why we have calculated the V square, because total energy at point B again equal to potential energy plus kinetic energy. And for kinetic energy, we having the formula half mv square. So what is the value of V square? We don't have any idea. So we have just calculated the value of V square from here. So kinetic energy equal to half m. In place of V square, we can substitute the value 2gh. So kinetic energy equal to mgh. Kinetic energy equal to mgh. While the potential energy equal to, potential energy equal to, only this height is here. So potential energy equal to mgh minus h. So this represent our kinetic energy, this represent our potential energy. So total energy equal to, from this formula, total energy equal to kinetic energy plus potential energy, that is equal to mgh minus h plus mgh. So total energy again equal इक्वल्स टू टोटल एनर्जी अगेन इक्वल्स टू एम जी एच. सो यू कैन नोटिस दिस एम जी एच अगेन इक्वल टू एम जी एच. सो टोटल एनर्जी एट पॉइंट बी ऑलवेज ऑल्सो रिमेन सेम. व्हाइल इन द थर्ड केस एट पॉइंट सी, सो बॉडी हैज कवर्ड अ टोटल डिस्टेंस एट पॉइंट सी, व्हाट हैपेंड, काइनेटिक एनर्जी बिकम जीरो बिकॉज द बॉल will come, at point C the potential energy becomes zero because height becomes zero, no height is there, and overall potential energy is converted into kinetic energy. So at point C total energy again equal to potential energy plus kinetic energy, and this potential energy becomes zero, and we need to determine the value of kinetic energy. So again kinetic energy equal to, we have in the formula half m v square. So for calculating the v square, suppose this covered a distance u square plus 2gh, total distance covered equal to 2gh. So starting from the rest, so value of the v square equal to 2gh, so kinetic energy equal to half m 2gh. So again you can notice that the value of the kinetic energy equal to mgh, and the value for the total energy equal to, so ultimately the total energy equal to mgh. So we can notice the value of total energy at point A equal to mgh, at point B equal to mgh, and at point C equal to mgh. This is how we proceed, and we can prove that the total energy, that is kinetic energy plus potential energy, always equal to constant. Now we'll cover the next topic, that the conservation of total energy will remain constant by taking example using simple pendulum. Suppose this is a simple pendulum. Suppose this is a position A, this is a bob. Okay. Suppose this bob is displaced to point B, and after swinging, it will again reach to its mean position, then to point C. Okay. So we can erase it. So there must be a, there will be a no confusion. Okay. So at A point, zero potential energy. At point A, zero potential energy is there. But if we displace bob to B, अगर मैं bob को B तक displace कर दिया तो at B point क्या होगा? It having potential energy will be there because it reaches at height h. It reaches at height h. There is a height h is there from the mean position. Okay. So, but at point B, kinetic energy will be minimum, or we can say zero. Kinetic energy will be minimum. Okay. Then again, it reaches a point A. What happens at point B? What will be the potential energy? We know very well. Suppose we have given some velocity. If we need to displace, we need to give some velocity. So v square equal to u square plus 2gh. So this is the initial velocity zero. So velocity at point B is 2gh, and this here, this kinetic energy is converted into potential energy. So this half mv square equal to, or we, we can directly use a formula. At point B, what happened? At point B, what happened? This kinetic energy is converted into mgh. So velocity will ultimately equal to 2gh. So what happened? The kinetic energy is converted into potential energy and having the velocity of under root 2gh. Now, when this bob is again reverse and swing and reaches the point A, so here at point A, kinetic energy will be maximum and potential energy will be minimum. Why? No height. Height is reduced, or we can say height is getting reduced. So at point A, this kinetic energy will be maximum, potential energy will be minimum. And due to this kinetic energy, again the same scenario will be repeated. Scenario will be repeated at point C. Again, it reaches up to a certain height h, and
So therefore, it having a potential energy maximum, and while the kinetic energy will be minimum. So we can conclude between AC and AB, there is kinetic energy and potential energy. There is kinetic energy and potential energy. ये region और ये region, यहाँ पे kinetic energy और potential energy दोनों हैं. But at point A, there is only a kinetic energy, but no potential energy. But at point B and C, what happened? There is only a potential energy, but no kinetic energy. Okay? Or suppose we need to draw a graph. So we can draw a graph in this manner. Okay? So this represents the here kinetic energy is maximum. This represents the kinetic energy, and this represents the this represents the potential energy, and this represents the kinetic energy. So at point A, kinetic energy is maximum, while the potential energy is zero. Here kinetic energy is equal to zero, potential energy at point A, kinetic energy is equal to zero, and here potential energy is maximum. While same here, kinetic energy यहाँ पे क्या हो गई जीरो, और potential energy यहाँ पे क्या हो गई maximum. ये दो पॉइंट हैं, these are the two points A, suppose this is a these are the two point x and y where kinetic energy equal to potential energy. This graph you will study in class 11, so no need to worry for that. I hope you all have understood. So this is the end of the chapter. For remaining numerical, we will proceed to our next class.